Thanks for tuning in. Anybody who's listening, please follow, like, comment, whatever you want. Just if there's something that you don't like, please say it. If there's something I can improve on, please let me know. I really would like to know how to improve my streams if anybody is listening. Anyway, we'll be continuing onwards with our stream. We will be continuing onwards with our Forge Guard spin to win. And see how far we can go. Thought we would have ran across it. I didn't expect the floor to open up with a hidden staircase. To remember to summon my armor. I almost forgot. Do a lot of damage. Cliff of Chaos. Finally leveled again. Hey, level 38. Okay, so with Warpath, this area per second, but it costs 4 extra mana. So for now, we will do the channeling cost for minus 2, and then with the next one we will go for area damage. Yo, Michi. Rebuke. Movement. Mana gained when hit. Healing, elemental damage. Augment. You have increased armor while channeling. Healing Manson. I think it really gives you buffers persist after channeling. Movement on end, cast speed. That's healing hit damage. Ignite. One per point. Okay. Still not sure if I want to continue onwards with that skill, of the armor skill, but I'm gonna increase it for now because it's actually good. It's almost going to level up anyway. Two there. Oh, 15%. Per point, and then regenerates 50%. Two in there. You get 3 points in here to get that whirlwind ability. It's strange that you can't get like a two-handed weapon for him. They really should have added a two-handed weapon for the armor ability. Oh, yeah, before I forget. Dexterity, increased throwing, nope. Got a one in here. Strength, increase health. Increase mana for Waterfront, 100% increase mana regen, cooldown recovery speed. Ooh, helmet. Legendary helmet on top of it. Blood Scorpion. That's a new one. Let's get down here. Please tell me there's a chest. No chest. Mana 14, increased spell damage, increased fire damage, increased fire spell cast speed. This is actually a fairly good item for a fire mage. I don't see any forge ability or any legendary. Okay. The game does feel a little bit empty, like there's not enough monsters sometimes. Like, I don't know if anybody else feels the same way, but for me it really feels like the game is a little bit empty. Because you get long stretches with no monsters at all, and then you get like a small batch where there's an increase of monsters who sometimes really a lot of them, and it just makes things weird. You would expect that there will be a consistent flow of a couple of enemies, but no. I guess it's understandable because, you know, not everybody wants to be constant in battle. Chests. Nothing. Just enemies. No chests. No great drops. Nothing. Just enemies. Want to offer you a promotion of your channel? Viewers, followers, view chats, bots. The price is lower than any competitor, the quality is guaranteed to be the best auto on incredible, flexible and convenient order. Management panel, everything is in your hands, turn it on, off, customize, go to... Huh. Interesting. I'll definitely think about it. Everything is in your hands, turn on, off, customize, go to... Doghard.com. Interesting. Of your channel. Oh, I want to offer promotions of your channel. Viewers, followers, views, chat spots, the prices lower than any competitor. Oh, it's guaranteed to be the best auto on incredible, flexible, and convenient order management. Okay. Interesting. Chased. Great. Sapphire Dome.
Ah!
UG hype. GHype.com. By Twitch, TravelKick Live viewer and followers get back to growth with the world's first ViewBot. So this is a ViewBot thing. Human method. I want to offer promotion of your channel, viewers, followers, views, chatbots. The price is lower than any competitor. This is very, very strange. Now, I appreciate the offer and all that, but this looks like, if I take a look at the webpage and all that now, I'm just quickly on my phone, just quickly trying to take a look at this whole Dodge hype thing. Never heard of it before, in all honesty. I really never have heard of it before. Now, from what I can see, and I would really like to get feedback from anybody who's watching, if anybody has heard of Dodge hype or dog, well, Dodge, it's D-O-G-E hype. Get back to growth with the world's first ViewBot platform. Your journey become an affiliated begins here. Live viewers and followers for all streaming platforms. Twitch our viewers. Select platform. Okay, let's see. Twitch, our, but there's no price. How's there no price? Sorry about that. I'm just quickly taking a look at this Dodger hype thing. Don't know it. I'll need to first do a little bit of research on it. I'm not saying no or anything like that, but the sound of ViewBots, it sets me a little bit off. But I guess we will see what comes off of it. I'm not going to just jump into it. I'm really first going to get some information about it, as I'm not really doing this for a business or anything like that. I'm really just doing this for the fun of it. But you know, if I do at the end of the day get a lot of followers and subscribers and all that, great, be it. But for now, I'm just concentrating on actually playing the game and having fun. I've got a new two-handed axe called Rendering Imperial Halberd. Increase melee damage, transignite, and increase minion. Okay, so 910. If we switch it out, it's 893. So two-handed sword. That looks actually very nice. What does it look like? Oh, okay. Blue in there. There's a shrine all the way down here. In the chase. Uncoordinates of life. Forging potentials of these things are not all that great. Something quickly. Let's just continue. The hell? This looks like a meat factory. Inventory. Increase melee damage. Oh, we increase it. I think the rest of my points I'll be investing into here. It's 9 points. The total is 9 points, so 2, 3. 3. 6. 7. Okay, I'll be able to do this. Twelve percent of cold damage taken as physical, 20% increased armor. I'm not really. I guess if your cold damage is not all that great, then or cold resistance is not all that great, and your physical armor is a lot better. Then I guess that helps. And carry on. Interesting. Timing is impeccable. Does it feel like I'm going to fight the mini boss or a boss or something? Yeah. Attacking from the front, otherwise it doesn't really do any damage. That is one disgusting enemy. Jeez. Increase void damage for 4 seconds when skill echoes. I'm not easy.
Too heavy.
Space. Let me go sell stuff. Okay, time to sell. Seven increased necrotic resistance, freeze rate multiplier, increased cost speed, increased leech rate, 910. 10. Yay. Let's see. Oh, minion increased minion damage for 29%. Dodge. Yeah, I believe we can go for this.
Can I help you?
Yeah, I'm not going to use that. Definitely.
Stay safe, Traveler.
Hey, second chance to fight this thing. Is incredibly fast.
Tell me your secrets.
Yeah, I've got a lot of necrotic resistances. Not pretty that much. Well, poison resistance is great. Strong shred armor on hit. Okay, the Magic's Way, Magellica Way. Wow. Oh. Oh, okay. Am I inside a stomach or what? This reminds me a lot of Grim Dawn at the moment.
This is the artificial waypoint. Can't say I'll enjoy using it. What we can do is wreck this place before we leave and let Zerik clean the mess. Quickly, on my signal, go to the center of the device and get ready. I'll get us out of here.
Yeah, we just trust everybody that we see.
watching us talk.
Shh. Don't be alarmed. The Emperor wants you dead. That makes us friends. You're trying to reach the Citadel. I know a path. Over there. Go. I want to say... I'll try to... Hopefully, I will see you soon.
Okay. So I was here, now I'm here. Okay.
I cannot do that.
Desecrated flesh, so that's what that thing is called. Grassland Stalker, Imperial Harbourless. Look at this. Unless I really need to give tip my hat, like they would say, for game developers to come up with all these weird names for enemies and creatures and skills and abilities. It's astonishing how they are able to keep bringing out new enemies and just come up with names. I don't believe it is all that easy. I struggle to just choose a name for a character, and here they go and keep continuing onwards to create different names for enemies and NPCs in the game. It's completely amazing. Oh, I'm back in the ancient era. Okay. Two-handed spear. I need to remember this ancient era. Just write that down. I need to remember this. horn. Like in corn. I almost thought they said corn, like in the corn cob. Patient Vine Walker of Shadows. So according to my map, I am in the ancient era, but where? The ancient era. Oh yeah, the verdant lake. But there's like no path, so it's a single area again. Hopefully there's a dragon or a big boss that I'm gonna fight again. It would be actually interesting. Familiar. How do you call this like a... Is this like a mini boss? Because it doesn't really feel like it. That was close. Ooh, a new ring. Spine rod, two-handed staff. I want to take a look at this ring. Chance to chill on hit, melee necrotic damage, cold resistance, and one maximum to skeleton. That's for the necromancer. Okay. Before I forget, I have leveled. Oh, Ring of Shields is going to be my new ability that I'm gonna get. Ring of Shields. Let's see how Ring of Shields is. It doesn't even last all that long. Okay, boss.
I cannot do that.
Relic. A lot of forging potential though. Increased mana regeneration, 13% increased cast speed with physical spells. So it'd be like Whirlwind, isn't it? Warpath. But that's not scaling tags, fire, melee area. Okay. Increase stun chance, increase health regen, increase physical spell damage. Okay, let's swap that around. Let's see, 927, 945. Now, I believe if Warpath. If. Wrong one. Skill Warpath. Where is it? Right over there. Still have 7 extra points. Dump 4 in there. I've got 3 left and then 3 into there. Okay. Because this does take base physical damage to fire damage. Okay, where to now? I've cleared it out now, so. Into the lower sewers. Is there now any other way to? Okay.
Unlucky?
I like this helmet. Okay, let's open the forge. This in there. So let's put the helmet in there first. Vengeance, increase melee damage, poison resistance, and health regen. I think we can make this a lot better. So first, what's this? Modifies the outcome of a craft. When upgrading an FX, prevents the roll on an FX within its range changing when it upgrades. I don't have a lot of prefixes for this. So there's vitality, strength, dexterity, attunement, and mana. Mana is the main thing. So add mana. Okay. Suffix. Cold resistance. What is my current helmet at the moment? My current helmet is poison resistance. What is my resistances? Cold. Okay, I need cold. So cold resistance would be a actually something that can be even better than cold resistance will be elemental resistance, because that's all your resistances. Okay. Another suffix. Fire resistance, health. Cortic, health regen per second. Armor, health regeneration. Physical resistance, endurance threshold. Armor, health. Cold dodge rating. So tier 3, tier 1, tier 1, tier 1. Two health regen, one vengeance shard, one poison resistance shard. That's actually quite interesting. Okay. Can jump back to that. Removes a random ethics. Rerolls the values of all ethics on items within there. Can't. Increase cost, speed, fire resistance. Throwing attack, melee damage, leech, freeze rate, multiplier. Prefixes mana, damage over time. Damage over time will be... There's no fire. Which makes sense.
may find a treasure, my friend.
Rustlands.
I cannot do that.
So I actually wanted to take a look at. Mana costs, shield health. Banding, heavy burden, pulsing shields. That's quite interesting. Collateral damage. While using Shield Rush, your shields form a wall in front of you, increasing the area you hit. Iron Form. Bastion. Reinforcement. From the bar. I'm still not certain what I will be using as my next. Ability. Get Shield Rush so late in the game. It's like only when you're level 40. I'm not saying it's a bad thing, but it's definitely something that comes late. So if I want to try that entire shield build, I'm gonna need to sit and properly think about which skills to use in the beginning of the game so that I can get back to there when I have all the rest of the skills. Another ring. Chance of shock on spell hits 6% chance to gain 75 war lightning damage. This is a set item. Interesting. Melee lightning. Yeah. Lower sewers.
Right. I'm willing to take her. I'll use my port. There should be some aqueducts up ahead. Let's meet there.
Sludge. It's just a different name for a slime. Ooh, haste. That's gonna make things a little bit funner. I keep thinking that my R button is for lunge. It's not for lunge at the moment. It's for the shields. For a little bit of extra defense.
Stand down or die.
I'm gonna change that back at the moment. Damage. Can just I wonder if this can actually cause damage. If you go down to the right and you go into this path, you can. Okay, interesting. I guess we'll keep it on for now. Check for Let's first go to the right. These ones look nice. Increase movement speed. Chance to shock on lightning. Increase shock durations. You are shocked for 4 seconds when you stop moving. So it's got a plus side and a negative. Cooldown recovery, increase health regeneration. So technically speaking, I will not lose anything. Okay, I'm standing still, they are moving. Increase melee critical chance. This makes life a little bit easier. Moving speed is wonderful. I really thought it would have shocked me, but it doesn't really shock you. Makes the right there. It doesn't bring my health down. Okay, so look, my health is currently 507. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, nothing. Say the increase of movement helps a lot. So let's move around. Move around, move around, move around. 507 health. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, nothing. Fallen Osprex, that's some weird names. Rune of Shattering. increase of movement speed. Oh, it's wonderful. Just think how fast you would be moving if you use shield right now. Click Spanish shield. Can use shields. This is a one shot straight to the top. Dagger. What's the dagger about? Missing half a grain on potions. One acid to flask. Increase area of effect of acid flask. This is also completely specialized for the rogue. Baron's Aqueducts.
Just like for one. And here I was, hoping this would lead us closer.
Hey there, wanna try your luck?
do it once more. Okay. Oh, there is a little boss. Wow, there's a lot of enemies. The map really does differ with the enemy scaling. One map you'll have to find an enemy for a while and then you get a lot, and then you get this where there's a lot more. Okay. Oh, dead end. To the bottom it is. Cost 40% area increase. Okay, that's a lot. That is quite a lot. Thank you. Let's see how wonderful our new warpath area is. Think it's huge. It's just it takes a lot of mana. Get this, yeah, I did. Great. Okay. I really need mana base. Sentinel Helm of Purity. Okay, that looks quite interesting. Engines. forge. Okay, let's see, 933, swap that out, 951, 21 mana, this one gives me 28 mana. Okay.
I'm glad we have seriously. Before you my ring, I'm too hurt. When he fled, I saw him heading deeper into the mountain.
I am Yulia because, in regards from there, the heart of the Citadel is beyond. There is an exit near the Emperor's throne.
New. Nest of the Fallen. No, first nest of the fallen. I need to remember to keep an eye on the mana. Spear, I don't use spears, so it's not gonna really help me. He really does a lot of damage. That's actually quite nice. Conduit. Resistance, poison resistance increased. Fire damage increase. Light. That's fine. Continue onwards. Back up top. I thought I killed this thing. Again!
This off. Maybe I can give her some good news for once, eh?
Okay, I think this is where I will be calling it quits for tonight. I will be streaming again tomorrow night from 8:30 in the evening. If I get time tomorrow morning, I'll stream also for about an hour tomorrow morning, maybe, if I get time. But definitely, I will definitely stream between 8 and 10 tomorrow evening again. Thank you for watching. If there's any comments, anything I can do to improve my stream, please let me know. Comment down below and please follow. If there's, if you go into my homepage on my channels page, you'll see there's also a donations tab. If you want to donate, you're more than welcome to. You don't have to if you don't want to. Thank you very much. Enjoy the evening.